So hi guys, welcome back to today's video. So today's topic will be a very common topic that people will tend to discuss about, and that is the difference between real estate and REITs, and so which is the better investment. So I'll be going over the difference between these two investment vehicles and go over which one will be more suitable for your personality. So real estate, as the definition means, is that it's the most common and popular form of property out there, which is usually the residential market. So when I talk about real estate, I mean the residential properties and not the commercial properties, because usually retail investors won't look into buying commercial properties. That can be a topic for another day. So whereas REITs refers to publicly traded companies. So what these companies do is that they allow you to own properties without physically owning any real estate at all. So what that means is that you are essentially a shareholder of the entire fund, of the entire company, and you are able to collect scheduled payments in the form of dividends. So if you want to look at which one makes more money, it depends on a multitude of factors, which is why it will be an inaccurate comparison if you purely look at monetary returns or the millionaires that make millions on whatever vehicle. Because if you look at it, there will always be millionaires making millions in any type of industry. So it doesn't mean that this is better than the other. It just means that there is people that will be successful no matter in which type of vehicle they're investing in. So instead, I'll be looking among the fundamental difference among the two. Then I'll be able to analyze and let you all know what are the differences so that you are able to make a better decision for yourself based on your personality and risk tolerance and the kind of resources that you have. So the first factor we look at is capital, meaning how much money is needed to invest into these things. So for real estate, you usually need a hefty sum of money because you have to pay for the down payment of the house. And although there are certain new projects nowadays that require little to no down payment, there are still deposits and fees such as stamp duty fees, legal fees, lawyer fees that you have to pay upfront that could add up to be a large figure, especially if you buy a house that is more expensive. However, if you are for REITs in comparison, it costs a lot less because it depends on the price of the REITs that is being publicly traded. So if you do have extra cash lying around, property, yes, is usually more lucrative and usually produces faster returns over a shorter period of time. But that's only if the property market is doing well, which is not really the case in this current environment because there's just an oversupply of properties. For me personally though, real estate just might have a little bit of edge over REITs in this category because of the larger returns that they're able to generate over a shorter period of time. I know that a lot of people may have differing opinions, but that's why in this video I'm only saying it based on my own personal opinions, and I might not be right because it really depends on what you think. So the next factor that I'll be going over will be expertise. So for real estate, you need to be operating within your realm of understanding and fully be aware of everything within the house, within the property industry, in order to purchase and make the best deals that you have that can provide you with the best return. So I know you all will say that, you know, doesn't that mean that REITs require the same expertise as well because you have to buy the right companies, buy the right REITs? As a matter of fact, it is a lot easier to understand and to choose a better REIT, REITs compared to the other, because you don't have to understand everything about it to be able to make money, because REITs are essentially professionally managed funds by professional real estate managers out there. So what you have to do is that you just have to choose a REIT that has a historical good returns over the years, and they have been consistently generating good dividends over the years. So as long as their property portfolio is also diversified enough and the properties are in good locations that you could see being popular over the next few years, and that place will still be a popular place for people to visit, then you can buy these REITs without fully understanding every single thing about it. So for example, there are REITs from Vanguard where it tracks the entire real estate market, and it usually gives a 12% annual return, which is much better than a lot of investments out there. So for me, definitely REITs take the advantage in this category. So the third factor that I'll be going over will be control. So what I mean by control is that, can you do a lot more with real estate compared to REITs, or vice versa? So definitely when it comes to control, you will have a lot more control with your own real estate because you can increase the value of your investment through your own hard work. So what I mean by that is that you can do certain renovations, you can beautify your place, you can even take nicer pictures, arrange the furniture in a better way that is more appeasing to the customer or tenants that you're looking for. So that way you'll be able to increase the value of the property, and you are able to essentially take advantage of economic situations like now, because the loan rates are a lot lower, and for people who do have cash lying around, they could essentially get a better deal of the properties. REITs, on the other hand, is a virtual investment in your phone or laptop whereby you don't have access to the physical real estate. So when the stock market crashes, you're not able to control and you cannot do anything about it, because at least for a house, when the market crashes or economic conditions are not good, like for example in this year, you are still able to at least live in it or collect rent at a lower price if you're willing to slash your rent prices. So even though it's not exactly the best situation out there, at least there is certain control or changes that can be made. You also cannot change or adjust the portfolio within the REITs as you wish, because that's done by the company or the professional property manager. So the only option you have is to either sell or buy more of the REITs. So real estate definitely wins for control, both in terms of the asset itself as well as the options you have to undertake and implement on the investment. So the fourth factor is diversification. So when it comes to diversification, I'm sure all of us will know that REITs are a no-brainer winner, because it's far more diversified than any amount of real estate you can own, because there is only so much real estate you can buy unless you are just filthy rich. So with one REIT, you can own commercial properties, you can earn multiple commercial properties, which is not something that a retail investor usually will be able to get their hands on. As a REIT investor, your clients are essentially tenants and customers going into shopping malls and making purchases from those shops. Because in turn, then the shop owners will be able to generate higher income, and they'll be able to pay rent to the mall owners, and the mall owners will be able to provide dividend to investors like us that invest in the REIT companies. So there's no need for troublesome things like background check for the tenants, credit reports, do the tenants have a bad history, do they have a bad financial payment history, and you don't have to worry about dealing with all the problems of the tenants, and you just have to sit back, relax, and get your dividends. So the fifth factor that I'll be comparing is taxes. So if you're investing in REITs in Malaysia, your dividend gains are not taxable, whereas if you invest into REITs in the US, the dividend gains are in fact taxable. So you have to be very careful about the location of your REITs you're investing in, because it really depends on the kind of taxes and the kind of laws each country implements on foreign or local investors. So for real estate, there are property gain tax, which is called a real property gains tax, that is charged on the capital gains of properties. And after a certain threshold of rental income, your rental income would be taxable as well. However, when it comes to real property gains tax, as of now, the government has waived it. So essentially, that is a tax that you can save and you don't have to pay. So the price of real estate will also affect the amount of taxes that will be charged and the amount of taxes that you'll pay, because there are various exemptions in relation to that. So that can be left in the future for another topic. So therefore, there is really no distinct clear winner in this category, because there's just too many factors that could affect the kind of taxes that you have to pay and taxes that you are charged on. So it really depends on the location and other factors as well. So the sixth factor that I'll be going through is liquidity. So REITs are essentially a lot easier to liquidate, because you can sell them during market hours on your phone, on your tablet, on your laptop, with just a few clicks of the button. Whereas in comparison, you might take weeks and usually months to sell a physical real estate. So even though you do get one huge lump sum of money when you sell the real estate, in terms of liquidity, it is far worse than the REITs. So the seventh factor is passive income. So when it comes to truly passive income, you simply just can't beat REITs, because dividend comes into your account automatically. You don't have to do anything, and you don't have to worry about bad tenants, maintenance, repair, finding the right tenants. You have to go and get plumbers, wiring, technicians, etc. So all these are essentially wasting time, because you have to go and spend time on all these things to get a good deal over a sale, over a purchase, or even to find a tenant. So that just takes up so much time, and REITs on the other hand just gives you a peace of mind and you can just sit back and relax. Of course, people would say that when it comes to real estate, you could still hire a property manager to do it for you, but that would be extra costs, and overall I think we all can agree that REITs can definitely be more passive compared to real estate. So when it comes to the ultimate question that everyone is wondering about, so which is better? But before we come to that, we have to understand, what does it mean by better? Does that mean just which one makes more money? So if that's the case, if you have enough money, you have the right experience, you have enough time, and you are willing to put in the effort and face the stress and all that, then I would say that you do make more money with physical real estate. Because your money is leveraged, the barrier to entry is higher. But if you are a good real estate investor, real estate can technically be better when it comes to monetary returns. However, if you're looking for an investment that you can start with less money, little to no work, little to no experience, and passive income that pays you well, and you would like the flexibility of being able to take the money and liquidate it at any time you want, REITs are definitely the better option because they are far more flexible. And if you want to avoid getting into debt, because I do understand that some people do not like getting into debt despite buying into real estate being a good debt, but there are just some people that can't face the stress or live with the fact that they are owing someone money. So for people like that, definitely you can choose REITs. And if you have the successful financial literacy to properly manage your good debts, then definitely REITs is also the better options for you. So personally for me, I invest in both to balance out my portfolio. And at the end of the day, you just have to choose the one that suits you better and choose something that you understand and something that you really are passionate or at least have interest in. So with that being said, we have come to the end of today's video. So I hope you all enjoyed this video. So do leave a like down below and subscribe to our channel. Do also leave a comment down below on what you think about real estate and REITs. And I hope you all enjoyed this video, and I hope to see you all in the next video. Bye bye.